other than the fact that I don't do this very often, somewhat what you're asking is for somebody to describe how they walk. They've been doing it for so long that it's difficult to put it to words. But in short, I'm always looking for stuff that I like. I drive around looking for stuff I like. I go to places, find stuff I like. When I say like, I'm looking not to make a photograph of something, but the stuff that would be potential paintings. I do this all the time. I make little notes in a sketchbook. If I can't stop and draw it at the time, I go back and make pastels. And I make whole bunches of pastels, probably 50 pastels for every 10 paintings. So one out of 10 comes to painting. When I'm in the diner looking at people, I'm not looking for beauty necessarily, or I'm looking for some type of, that I have some type of relationship with the person I'm drawing. And it's, the relationship is pretty much all in my head because I don't necessarily know them. Most of the time I don't know them. You know, outside when I'm driving around, I'm looking for stuff that has an abstract relationship. The colors interact well with each other, or there's something in there that there's an implied movement that you can recognize. I drew a gas station the other day up in Old York Road, and I've drawn it over the years probably 4 or 5 times. And every time I think I've got a masterpiece. The last time I drew it, it's got a big red, it's a Luke oil, it's got a big red banner that goes this way. But beyond that was a muffler place with a bright yellow banner that went across. And opposed to the black, opposed to the yellow, there was the black base. So there's like a series of black marks underneath the yellow, underneath the red. So it has this potential for a variety of abstract relationships that exist within a fairly everyday scene. And I like finding scenes like that. I like finding stuff in my everyday life that is neat, as opposed to the beautiful sunset or the beautiful this or the beautiful that. I like finding stuff that, oh, that was nice. Unexpected. Then I'm on the Paul Krasner grant. You know, this morning, I paint. And I can afford to paint thick. And painting thick is different because the way the colors interact is different when the colors are thick enough so that the color you put on top of it changes or interacts with the color underneath it, as opposed to just covering it. And that's a different interaction. Definitely. Kind of do these things without any great expectation because it's kind of like winning the lottery. You know? You buy a ticket, but I'm not sure that other than that you really have any great expectation. But I did win. And it was like, that was 20 grand.
Wow.
Maybe.
And that was in what, 2000?
I don't know. I think it was 2000. And they gave you 10 grand 1 year, 10 grand the next year. That you went killed on taxes. But you know, that was a lot of money. That basically eliminated my concerns with money for a good portion of the year.
And you were saying that sort of gave you the ability to start painting thicker, obviously.
Yeah, I mean, I always liked paint. Even when I first began, I liked the idea of paint as a stuff. You know, I liked gooeys, brights. I like paint. That's why I paint with oils and potions. Acrylics, not now, years ago they used to be kind of like thick watercolors, and that same body. So yeah, I don't know.
Other than money, what did that change for you as far as receiving a grant or anything?
No, not a damn thing. I thought it would. I thought I have ties and sent stuff to galleries and said I just want a pot of crafts and I'm wonderful, I want to show my paintings. And they didn't share the opinion, I guess. I thought it would do more. No, selling art's difficult. I mean, for some people it's easier. I think that if they're doing, especially in Philadelphia, they're doing realistic work, there's a fairly strong market for that. I think. I don't know how successful the people I'm thinking of really are, but they seem to be doing okay. But if you're not part of that group of painters, I think it's hard for people to take a leap. Hard to believe that, like, I had a gallery owner years and years ago who basically said, well, you know, that he was saying that one of the people he was showing spent months on the paintings. And I said back to him, well, I spent a long time on my paintings as well. He says, well, you basically paint El Prima, you know, go out and paint and done. And I said, well, no, that's not really true. I spent, you know, a month ahead of time before I paint. So the deception is somehow I knock it off. It's disturbing or ignorant or, but I guess that people generally feel probably that way. It's just, you're very talented, you just knocked it off. Well, it didn't just knock it off.
Well, I feel like that's like one of the most important things about what we're doing here with this discussion, because I think most people, when they see your paintings maybe for the first time, they think that they're done very quickly and in the moment and sort of spontaneous, which there's an element of that is true. But they don't realize that there's months of preparation leading up to that spontaneous moment of pain.
I mean, I equate it to a jazz musician. And the guy goes out and plays with a bunch of other people and it's never quite the same. But all week long, you played. And all week long, you played the same similar thing and rehearsed it and made sure that the progression from here to here wasn't the first time you ever did that. Any more than the first time somebody tells a football player to curse all week long so that they can possibly get it right, you know, on the game.
So, I mean, essentially, made this reference in a few different pieces, like pieces of writing where, you know, it's sort of the rehearsal leading up to that performance.
That's all, yeah. And as time has gone on, it's been there's been more and more rehearsal and more selection.
And
so that hopefully the performance won't just be a mundane copy of something that's already happened before, but something new, both the thing I'm painting into myself. Yeah. Some of the best paintings are paintings that ended up the way I thought they were going to end up when I began. And some of the paintings that were the most mediocre ended up exactly how I wanted to do it. And I walked away and it's like, well, I did everything I wanted to do and
it didn't work out.
That wasn't enough.
Yeah.